This real-time stats bar will show you everything you need to know about your channel when you are on any YouTube page. Hover over the graph to show detailed breakdowns of the analytics and customize the stats bar itself. If you do a search on YouTube, this information panel down the right-hand side is full of information. If you enable inline keywords, you can view all the tags that have been used on the most popular videos for your search term. The keyword score will show how popular the keyword is against how many videos contain it. If it's a popular term with low competition, think about making videos that target that keyword. Next up are top related queries to your current search term and rising keywords. These keywords are good indicators of what's trending on YouTube, so definitely want to keep a good eye on. As well as related queries, vidIQ's search panel will also list top keywords for the topic. Hover your mouse over any of these words to reveal the volume of monthly searches and the keyword score. Of course, there can be hundreds of top keywords, and we try our best to list them all. At the bottom of the keywords list, we'll showcase some of the trending videos for that search term because YouTube doesn't always show you what's hot right now. And if you want to delve much deeper into any keyword, simply click on it to launch the Keyword Inspector. This will show interest over time from the last 30 days, last year, or all time. Very useful for finding trending topics and evergreen content. And one last thing on the search page is this handy breakdown of average video views, average age of video, top channel creator, and so much more. On the channel page of every single YouTuber on the planet, we've added analytics that include estimated revenue, total channel views, daily average views, daily subscribers, and views and subscribers over the last 30 days. Just below that, you'll find the channel tags as well. You may have also noticed this trending tab. This shows you videos that are hot on the channel right now, as they are sorted by views per hour. As you can see, one of these videos is over a month old, but it's still getting a lot of views. If you spotted the top keywords button, good job, because that's where we're going next. This shows you the top keywords from all those trending videos, along with two useful features. The first copies all these keywords to your clipboard, while the second drills down into those keywords to show you how often they appear in the trending videos, as well as the overall search volume of the keywords on YouTube. Some pretty impressive insider knowledge right there, yeah? Well, that's just the tip of a very large analytical iceberg. Now let's introduce you to the video scorecard, which reveals a wealth of analytics for every single video on YouTube. You can expand and minimize the whole panel down the right hand side, or minimize individual sections. Let's take a closer look. The overview estimates the earnings of a video, views per hour, engagement, how many subscribers the video earned for the channel, average view duration, and more. All of this feeds into the vidIQ score. For your own videos, it will also tell you how your videos are watched and from where. Important for deciding how you make your videos, for whom, and when to publish them. Engagement comes next, telling you everything you need to know from a YouTube angle, along with other social media platforms. The discoverability of a video is the key to YouTube success, and our search engine optimization panel has loads of useful information. You can mouse over many of these numbers to reveal more details, such as the breakdown of our SEO score calculator, traffic from other YouTube videos, and embedded sources. If you've ever wanted to know why a video is so successful or unsuccessful, this will tell you exactly why. You've already seen the channel analytics displayed on the channel page, so let's move on to video tags. This shows you all the keywords used for a video and where they rank on the first page of any YouTube search for that keyword. You have those tools in the top right hand corner to copy keywords or drill deeper into them. You can click on a tag to launch the keyword inspector, and if it's your own video, you can quickly add more keywords. Incredibly, this is just the first panel of the video scorecard. We also have historical growth, social media shares, and what videos are trending in the same topic. But we're not just about analyzing your audience, we also build tools to help you engage with your audience, which is why we have the comment template builder. For any comment on one of your videos, you can use the vidIQ button to pre-select a template comment. So, no more copying and pasting from a text file. If you have to respond to the same question over and over again, or you just want to say a simple thank you, this tool enables you to do it in seconds. Oh, and I'm sure you'll be delighted to hear that this tool is also available from YouTube's central comments page, so you can manage all of the comments for your channel via the template tool. Speaking of managing stuff, let's move on to the video manager tools. The vidIQ button seated next to every video includes a wide set of tools. These include setting a video as your feature video. This option is usually hidden deep within YouTube's video manager. A copy card facility that lets you choose one, some, or all of the cards from one video and then copy them to one, some, or all of your other videos. An end screen copy facility that does exactly the same thing for promotional material that appears at the conclusion of your videos. A social media syndication tool that enables you to send a YouTube video directly to your Facebook page within the space of 30 seconds and 4 or 5 mouse clicks. And last but not least, there is a fully functional thumbnail editor where you can select any frame you want from the video and then add text to it along with emojis, because who doesn't like an emoji in their thumbnail? A couple more tools before we move on. At the top of the video manager page, you can edit video cards and end screens on a mass scale. And if you want to add some text to the video description of some, many, or all of your videos for a limited period of time, say for example during a giveaway, you can take advantage of the bulk descriptions tool. Now, we all know the upload process can be an intense affair, so here's a few things to assist. Character counts and limits are added to titles, descriptions, and tags, so you never go over those limits. You will also find an emoji inserter tool that you can add to titles and descriptions, because if you haven't already established, we love emojis. As you continue your upload process, the SEO score will dynamically update to let you know whether you're optimizing your tags, titles, and descriptions correctly. And just below that is the upload checklist that lists 8 important actions you need to take during the upload process and after video publication. Rather handily, each of these suggestions include direct links to take the necessary actions. In this case, setting up your video cards. For the final piece of the upload jigsaw puzzle, when you use high volume tags, you can mouse over those tags for more information. And furthermore, if you have vidIQ boost access, the lower section of the upload page recommends other tags you should use. All you need to do is click on the plus button to add it to your own tags. And if you're interested to know similar videos to yours that are trending, those are shown on the right hand side. So, have you had enough yet? Nope, let's carry on then. Two tabs that have been added by vidIQ to the YouTube homepage are competitors and trend alerts. The competitors tab allows you to add YouTube channels to a list where videos are then sorted by views per hour. That tells you what videos are performing well for channels that you're interested in as a YouTuber yourself. The trend alert tab, on the other hand, lets you create a custom filter that lists trending videos for specific keywords over a certain views per hour threshold over a set period of time. And what makes this tool even better is that it will email you that list so you never miss out on content that's trending that's specific to your interests. Let's return to YouTube itself now for a few more handy tools. The comment filter tool helps you pick out such things as questions, comments with positive or negative words, as well as comments from specific users. You can even bundle different criteria together if you want to search for comments that contain questions that you haven't responded to yet that include positive words. And if that's not enough, if you want to search for influential YouTubers, you can search by a minimum number of subscribers. At the same time as filtering those commenters, it will also show you exactly how many subscribers the commenter has. These comment filter tools are available from both the YouTube Comment Manager page and from your individual video pages. On the same subjects as your own videos, you can click the vidIQ tool button to copy video cards, send a video to Facebook, create thumbnails, and more. That same button on other YouTubers' videos only allows you to embed the video. At the bottom of video thumbnails on YouTube, you will see this blue red bar. This shows you the likes to dislikes ratio, very good for sniffing out clickbaity videos. Below that is an engagement snapshot of a video, and you can mouse over it for even more information. On the video card creation screen, once you've finished making your cards, you can save them as a template and then load them into other videos, saving you the hassle of manually creating the cards all over again. Now, if by chance you don't like the real-time stats bar or the thumbnail likes dislikes bar, you can turn them off by clicking on the vidIQ button and choosing settings at the very bottom. Two simple checkboxes here allow you to turn both features off if you want to, so that your YouTube pages will change from looking like this to looking like this. Now, these are all tools that are embedded into YouTube's website, but we've got dozens more to show you from vidIQ's own web applications. Let's take a look. Once you have the vidIQ Chrome extension installed, you will see a button in your browser. Click it and you will find two sets of shortcuts. The first provides links to all the major YouTube pages. So wherever you are on the internet, you can always jump straight to where you want to be on YouTube with these links. The second set of shortcuts link to vidIQ's own web applications, full of fantastic YouTube tools, so let's delve right in. Analytics is our first destination with a wide range of enhanced YouTube analytics. You can minimize many of the panels or move them about to bring the ones that interest you the most to the top of the page. As well as minimizing panels, some of them can be expanded to reveal more information, such as the playlist panel. Now let's take a look at some of the analytics in more detail. The best time to post panel tracks when your subscribers are most active on YouTube to calculate when the best time is to publish your videos. In this example, prime hotspots are weekends and the afternoons. The trend analytics is good for taking a snapshot of your channel's general health, tracking growth over 7 and 30 day periods. You'll also find these three top panels that you can customize between top YouTube searches for your videos, most views from which country, most embedded views, and most video views over a 30-day period. And if you've ever wanted a graph that collates YouTube views, minutes watched, likes, dislikes, subscribers gained, subscribers lost, and comments for each and every single day all into one, well, you'll find it right here. At the top of the vidIQ web apps page, you'll find links to other tools, so let's take a look at the video page next. Just like the native YouTube Video Manager page, this does list important analytics for your videos, but the settings button in the top left-hand corner allows you to add and remove statistics to match your preferences. Some of the columns will either offer suggestions, such as adding tags for videos where none exist. If you click on a video, a panel to the right-hand side will sweep in to give you even more analytics, as well as tools to edit the video title and description, schedule a video to be published, delete the video, and so on. Now, if you've connected your Facebook Pages account to vidIQ, you can look at the performance of your Facebook videos too, which will be quite useful if you're sending your content from YouTube to Facebook through vidIQ's syndication tool. The tools just keep on coming with subscriber analysis. This takes a sample of your current subscribers and tracks what videos they are liking from other video makers as well as other YouTubers they are subscribing to. It stands to reason that some of this content will be similar to yours, so you might want to go check these videos and channels out for yourself. See if there are any techniques you could adopt or similar channels you can collaborate with. And as you might expect, each of these videos and channels include direct links back to YouTube. Let's return now to the topic of search engine optimization, because the next vidIQ web app tab is full of useful tools. Bulk SEO is the first on the list. This shows you how well your tags are performing for a video by counting how many times a search term has brought a viewer to that video. Sometimes viewers may even be finding your video through a search term you've not even added to your video tags, so this is the perfect opportunity to add that tag to your video to help improve its discoverability. You can also quickly edit your video title and description here to include words and phrases from the most popular search tags, and you can sort the video list either by best opportunities to optimize or most recently analyzed, which is done on a daily basis. Channel-wide tags harvest all of the tags from all of your videos to see how well they perform. You can sort by any of the columns, so it's interesting to see if a tag you use ranks on the first page of a YouTube search for that tag and how many times your videos rank for the search term. If you do rank highly and frequently, that means you're doing a good job within a particular search term. The last three columns calculate the score of the search term to help you decide whether it's a term that's high in demand and if you can realistically compete with other channels for that search term. If any of the tags you see on this page are of particular interest, you can highlight them in order to copy them. And if you want to see how tags you use are shifting over time, you can set a period of time. So you might see best ranked tags go up, search volumes go down, and how overall tag scores fluctuate over time. If the channel-wide tags page focuses on your own tags, the keyword research tool gives you the power to search for any keyword and see how well it performs on YouTube. You can use this tool to research, compare, and sort related keywords, search volume, competition score, and number of words, which is really useful for discovering long-tail keywords. This is the sort of tool that can help you build an entire channel, and of course a copy tags feature is included. For an overview of what content is popular right now, the trending keywords tab is the place to be. These keywords and videos will change frequently, which is why you have options to choose keywords over the last day or week, and which YouTube category to look at. Alright, this next one is an absolute monster, so strap yourselves in. Simply take any username from a YouTube channel and add it via the Compare Channels box, and this will give you an instant comparison for all sorts of datasets, such as views, subscribers, average daily views, average daily subscribers, and so on. You can choose to look at this data as totals, cumulative, or daily over 30 days, 60 days, or all time. And things start to get really interesting when you add several channels into the mix. We call this the competitors tool, and it will give you an insight into how channels like yours are performing. So, if a competitor enjoys a sudden spike in viewership, you might want to look at their channel and see what content you might have missed. We're not finished yet, however, because underneath the graph, channel snapshots will display which way the channel is trending over the last month, and below that, you can see which videos are trending for the selected channels as they are sorted by views per hour. Also note that any channels you add to the competitor analysis page directly feed into the competitors tab on YouTube and can also be used in trend alert searches. Oh, and if I'm going too quickly through any of these tools, you can find much deeper dives into each feature on the vidIQ YouTube channel, so don't forget to check that out. In fact, maybe subscribing to vidIQ is the best tool of the lot. And that, ladies and gentlemen, brings to a conclusion the most comprehensive set of YouTube tools anywhere on the planet. If you want to start using any of these, many of which are free, all you need to do is click on the link in the video description below to download the vidIQ Chrome extension. Now, as a final thought, we'd love to hear your opinions on what you think is the best tool that you've seen today. And if you would like to see any other tools, of course, let us know in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching. Enjoy your video making day. Bye for now.